Something finally became possible that was previously impossible. You see, when creating a movie or video game, digital artists spend weeks animating a character's fur or a hero's whip. But if the physics engine behind it isn't stable, oh god, the whole thing just falls apart. The artist then has to go in and fix every single frame by hand. Ooh, it is grueling, expensive work. Now, this insane research paper gives us a method that is so robust, the artist can just hit play and let the physics do the heavy lifting. Okay, but is it stable enough for our crazy scholarly tests? It seems that it can do hair, trees, cloth, down to the level of individual yarns, slingshots, bridges, you name it. Amazing! Let's run the full tests and see how it goes. And then we'll try to do something extreme. I'll try to explain how it works. Now that will be something. Whoa! This is Vertex Block Descent, something we've talked about here already that is a blockbuster research paper. However, when modeling a bridge against a Category 5 hurricane, bro couldn't stand a chance, man. Holy cow, that's some destruction. And the new technique, ooh, still stable. Now, we'll destroy that one too though. This is 2-minute papers. Yep, but we destroyed it in a numerically stable, realistic way. Loving it. Next up, a piece of cloth simulated not just as a textured sheet of paper, nope, 65,000 individual strands moving naturally. And all this in real time, this is insanity. And check out this big afro, nearly 1.5 million vertices bouncing around. The character shakes its massive head of hair, and everything wiggles around realistically. It's so funny. Almost 1.5 million simulation elements in just 7 milliseconds per frame. Easily faster than real time. You see, most other hair simulations cheat by simulating just a few guide strands and having the rest follow these strands, but not this. This crazy thing computes the physics for the massive bulk of hair all at once. Now, knitted letters with 250,000 vertices. I absolutely love how realistically they are hanging there by just a couple of threads. Steer runs interactively. Can you believe this? Not real time, but you could grab a mouse pointer and start pulling at things and enjoying the results immediately. Not so long ago, you needed a supercomputer for this. Now, just one GPU. This feels like science fiction to me. This Linky is simulated with the previous discrete elastic rods technique from 8 years ago, and the new one next to it. And, ooh, look at that. We are now 45 times faster. I'm out of words. Now, I'll note that they look a tiny bit different, and I believe that the previous technique is a bit more accurate here. But the point here is that this is one of the worst possible cases for the new technique, and it is still very close, and 45x faster. And what I absolutely loved here, in this unassuming sling scene, is that it contains multiple materials. The rubber band is more than 1,000 times more elastic than the handle, and it still handles extreme deformation. Simulating such a massive disparity in material stiffness would make many other previous techniques explode instantly. But this one? Doesn't even seem to break a sweat. Insanity. And now I'll try to explain how it works. Now, hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, because no AI is used here. Only human ingenuity. Let's dive in. Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai-Fehér. Okay, now imagine a tree branch being animated in a movie. Previous methods struggle to solve position and rotation simultaneously. If you run the simulation too quickly, the math fails, causing the branches to fall apart. Yes, this is a mathematical car crash, forcing us to take tiny little steps instead. And that, fellow scholars, is how you get a super slow simulation. And this incredible new technique does this with what they call carceret rods. This technique is finally able to track every single spat along the branch, and for each spat, it knows exactly how stretched, bent, and twisted it is. This is why the trees here in this video look so great. Every branch resists forces and twists just like in reality. Okay, but how? Well, imagine trying to build a brick wall. There are two things we need to do. One, lay the bricks. This is the quick and easy part. The hard part is that you have to add the mortar before you lay the next brick. And imagine you have to wait until it dries. Lay one brick, add the mortar, wait a lot. Lay the brick, add the mortar, wait a lot. Not a great workflow. However, to have a highly accurate simulation, this is what you need to do. Otherwise, the whole thing will wobble and crash. Now, the new technique does not do that. This is crazy. Imagine that it lays all the bricks at once. Then it sprays the whole brick wall with foam that dries instantly. Finally, there is no need to stop and wait. So, it builds the wall instantly, and it does it with near-perfect stability and super quickly. Now, when research scientists are talking among each other, you could summarize what we just said the following way. They introduce a split position and rotation optimization scheme with a closed-form Gauss-Seidel quasi-static orientation update to achieve robust numerical stability under large time steps. Admit it right now. That sounds amazing. So good. Okay, now, this instant drying process is absolutely amazing, but surprisingly, it is sometimes a bit too fast. Yes, you heard it right. The instant foam has a downside. It assumed that bricks and mortar, so positions and rotations, don't need to talk to each other during the drying process. This comes up in very specific, complex scenarios, like a knot tightening extremely fast or a rod being crushed from multiple directions. In these cases, previous methods can be a bit more accurate. Why? Well, with instant foam, you might realize too late that, oh no, a brick is slightly out of alignment. Well, too late now. But with the old, slower method, you can give a good old nudge to the brick to put it into its place while the mortar is still wet. So, for computer games and movies, the difference is absolutely invisible. But for high-precision, scientific engineering and simulating surgery, this tiny loss might matter. Use the old stuff for that. For everything else, use this. And scientists give this technique away for all of us for free for the benefit of humanity. Source code is also available. What a time to be alive! And it just breaks my heart to see a masterpiece like this sitting at just 1500 views. These papers are truly like endangered species. I'm trying my best to save them because nobody else is doing it. And believe me, the YouTube algorithm often leaves these videos in the dust. But we do it, because this science is beautiful, and it deserves to be seen. If you wish to help us out, subscribe, hit the bell, and leave a really kind comment, and the algorithm will give more of this good stuff to you. And I would like to send a huge thank you for Lambda, because they get it. They support us and let us do our crazy thing. So please make sure to check them out and give them some love through the link in the description. Here you see me running the full DeepSeek AI model through Lambda GPU Cloud. 671 billion parameters, running super fast and super reliably. This is insane. I love it, and I use it on a regular basis. Lambda provides you with powerful NVIDIA GPUs to run your own chatbots and experiments. Seriously, try it out now at lambda.ai/papers or click the link in the description.